All these amazing images that you see on the screen are generated by Google's ImageGen 4 model. So for those who don't know, ImageGen is Google's best model for image generation. So let's see how you can use this model. So for this, just Google Google AI Studio and select the first link and make sure that you are signing in with your Google account. Once you do that, you will be having an option called as generate media over here. Click it, and here we will be having ImageGen under explore models. Select it, and you will be getting an interface like this where we can input our text prompt and run it to generate images. And to the right, we will be having a place to change the model as well as the aspect ratio. So if I click the model drop down, currently there are three models available for us to generate images. One is ImageGen 4, which is in preview mode, and next is ImageGen 4 Ultra, which is also in the preview mode, and also we are having ImageGen 3 model. So let's generate ImageGen 4 and ImageGen 4 Ultra models. So I'll just open it in a new tab, and in one tab I will have ImageGen 4 and in another tab I will be having ImageGen 4 Ultra. Alright, and for testing this, I am having these many prompts available. This basically tests each and every aspect. For example, this one tests its text rendering one, and next is the hyper realistic human face and indoor lighting. We are having sci-fi test, so we are having different prompts. So I'll just go with like quite a few and compare these models how good it is. So first one is going to be the text rendering test. Not only these models are good in generating images, as you can see, we can generate some posters like this. So we can just try it out now. So let me just go with this particular prompt. This is with ImageGen 4, and next I will go with ImageGen 4 Preview Ultra. So that's not bad from ImageGen 4. It literally gave what we asked in the prompt. Dream big, work hard in 3D gold letters. And let's see what Ultra has given us. Ultra has done it in a more refined way, and I really like the background in the Ultra, like the sun rays coming over it. So I would go with the ImageGen 4 Ultra, does better over here. So now let's see the next prompt. Next prompt is going to be more serious. It's going to be like a hyper realistic close-up portrait of a woman. So we are going to test how good it's generating in human skin. Like, we need to have this wrinkles and stuff on the face. So let's see what both gives us. And this is what I get for ImageGen 4. That looks stunning. That looks super realistic. And let's see the size of the image, and that's more than 1000 KB. So seriously, this is like super realistic image. And now let's go with Ultra, and boom, that looks stunning. It literally looks like a photo that's taken out of a DSLR camera. And this is also like quite similar in the size, and both those things are doing an amazing job in realism. And especially the skin texture, as you can see, the wrinkles, the coloring, it has done an amazing job in replicating realism. And next prompt, let's test the indoor lighting and shadow effect. So this is going to be the prompt. Cozy living room at night, we are having some fireplace and light. So let's see what it gives us. These are the images it has generated, and a cat is sleeping on the blanket covered by sofa with the ambient lighting. I really like the vibe of this image, and the cat looks super realistic. And another great factor about this image is that here you are able to see, right, the entire background is out of focus and only the cat is on focus. So that makes it even more lively, this image. And this is ImageGen 4 only. Now let's see ImageGen Ultra, and it has also done a pretty good job. Similar results, the background is blurred and the cat looks super realistic. Nobody would believe if this is going to be an AI generated image. That is an amazing job there. Next, let's go with product photography test. Imagine you are building a product and you want to like showcase it. You want like a mock of that product. You can just go with this one. Here we are having a sleek black smartphone placed on a marble surface. So let's see what it can generate for this. And we have got the output for this. That's insane. I can't say any words. This is words apart. That's how perfect ImageGen 4 is. Looks stunning. And look at the ImageGen 4 Ultra. This is also like perfect. And I really like the marble effect. This one, like the white marble effect, and the lighting also, the shadow, how it falls on the phone. And next, let's go with this typography integration test. So this is basically adding a particular text on a wall, like a painted format. So let's see what it gives this for this prompt. And this is the output that I get for image gen 4, and I don't know, I'm literally out of words. This looks that perfect. Like, literally look at this particular portion of the image, right? How realistic the bricks are looking, especially the part where like the paint is dripping. This looks super realistic, and I really like how it has integrated the image, and I don't know, this is literally super realism. And next, with the ultra realistic one, same thing. I really like the brick texture on this image. That it looks super super realistic. The resemblance is totally like a real world picture taken on the streets. That's how realistic this looks. And this is the result that we are getting: a lone man walking across a desert at dusk, and we are having the shadow, golden hour, which is the sunset, and dramatic tone. And that looks so good. This image looks literally like a picture taken out of a movie. This is for Image Gen 4, and this is for Image Gen 4 Ultra. This is like a picture that you take in like Middle East. Like, that's how good it is. It literally looks like a Instagram post. That's how good this image looks. And these are some of the things that I tested out, and for me, Image Gen 4 is super good. Like, you can literally use it absolutely for free over here. And I'm not exactly sure about the limit. As far as now, I literally generated around like 5 to 10 images, and it hasn't even given me a limit. So you can just try using this and let me know in the comments how you feel about it. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.